This is a big day for Floyd Mayweather. On Twitter, he passed 2 million followers. Manny Pacquiao, very popular fighter, some say the most popular, has 300,000 followers on Twitter. You may say, what I'm hearing from my friends in the Philippines, that there's no internet in the Philippines, it's too expensive. I'm here with George Diaz, boxing trainer. What do you say about what you just heard? Floyd, 2 million followers on Twitter, very impressive for any athlete, for any celebrity. Great for boxing.
Yeah,
that's 300,000.
That means that he has a big following. People, you know, probably like what he does. You know, what he's accomplished. You know, that's the reason they're following. Maybe they hate him. Maybe they like him. They're following for a reason. They want to hear the latest news.
And what do you say that Manny has only 300,000? 300,000 is a lot, man.
It's still a lot. You can't take nothing away from Manny. You know, he got the following, you know.
He sells out every fight.
You know,
he carries a country in his shoulders.
Exactly. So, you know, I don't want to knock the Filipino people and the Philippines. Maybe they don't have internet access, you know, because that is a third world country. But imagine if that was not a third world country. Everybody would have internet.
Manny would have 97 million followers.
Exactly. So
The two haters, the two Filipino haters I met somewhere along the line.
You know, but you know, you gotta name all. You know, you call them haters, you could call them non-haters, you could call them, they speak the truth or not the truth. You know, people call me a hater, some people say I speak the truth. Whatever the issue is, everybody can speak their mind.
George, I gotta ask you this. Mm-hmm. If I'm here at the gym, I'm working out today, I wanna work out, I wanna train like Floyd. Can you show me a move? How does Floyd, what can I train? Show me for a second, how can I move like Floyd today?
Show me in the back. It's not about, this is the difference. You know, training like Floyd is not really, you know, you could do it, you could watch Floyd, he does a shoulder roll, but the thing is, you wanna know what is it for. Me personally, I haven't mastered it. I'm not gonna say, I teach it. I don't teach it.
Okay, you know, can you teach me to hit like Manny with the angles? Show me that, how to do that.
That's, you know, you're gonna be left-handed.
I am a left-handed.
Punches, you know, what Manny does is he throws punches and then he steps out to the right and turns out.
Wait, one more time.
He throws punches, he comes in, and then when he throws a single shot, big shot, he moves out of place.
But he does it a little faster.
Yeah, a little faster. I'm just trying to slow it down. You know, that's one thing that Manny's been successful. He has good leg movement, good footwork. But you saw that with Marquez, it didn't really happen.
Why not?
Marquez was actually kept his distance, was aware of Manny's moves, and every move that Manny was making, he was probably one step or two steps ahead of Manny.
Can you show me how Marquez moves? If I wanted to box like Marquez, because he's a great boxer.
You know, that's more basic boxing. He keeps his hands like a textbook. You look at the textbook of boxing, they tell you how you keep your footwork, how you keep your hands. That's textbook boxing. So he's a very technical.
He's the only superstar that's a textbook superstar.
Yeah,
everybody else is so unique.
Yeah, you're right.
But Mayweather is Mayweather. Manny is Manny. Sergio Martinez, do Sergio for a second.
Who? Sergio Martinez? Yeah. No, Sergio Martinez, he's you know, I know I did call him a seasoned fighter, but he's more of an athletic fighter. You know, he'll do moves that, you know, he will do moves that
like a chicken.
Athletic fighters would do. Roy Jones, for example. Roy Jones wasn't technically correct.
The new champion, Roy Jones. He just won a title.
Yeah.
Hey, you win a title, I don't care if it's the...
It's still in the history books, that's what matters.
Good for him, he's still fighting.
They may not consider him as a world champion, but you know, a title's a title, and whatever is an honor to hold a title, whatever title you hold on your shoulder, it's an honor to hold.
So back to the point that all these superstars are so unique except Marquez, how is he successful just being a boxer from a textbook?
His training. Nacho Bernstein, that's his signature style. That's what he teach. You gotta look at Ricardo Lopez. Back, you know, Ricardo Lopez was also a fighter that Nacho Bernstein trains. He also trained Chiquita Gonzalez, that actually beat Michael Carbajal. You know, he Michael Carbajal beat him, then Chiquita came and beat Michael Carbajal because he switched training. He started training with Nacho Bernstein. You know, Juan Manuel Marquez's brother, Rafael Marquez, also has that style. But he's more of a, he's technically correct, but he's more of a puncher.
Dude, every fight he has, it's my last fight, I'm fighting last, and then he comes back 6 months later. Dude, how many times are you going to retire? What, are you too short, take out 8 CDs and say it's my last CD, go buy one?
You know something, you know, he just, he's, I'm not going to say he's bitter, maybe he's seen that his brother's been having a lot of success, you know, coming back, you know, because, you know, he just lost to Manny. He lost to Floyd. You know, I personally thought Marquez was done when he fought Casamayor. But, you know, I knew personally, I thought Casamayor was going to beat him. He shocked me. He knocked out Casamayor, who's never been knocked out at that stage of his career. You know, Casamayor just came from a, he was losing to Michael Katsidis, and he knocks him out. He was hurt in that fight, and he knocks him out.
Was he high in that fight?
I don't know. You gotta find out through them. But you know, so I said, you know, he knocked out Katsidis. I think he's gonna beat Marquez. The same thing when Marquez fought Juan Manuel Marquez fought Juan Diaz the first fight. I said, Juan Manuel's too small. He's gonna lose that fight. What he
fight
did?
Of the year.
He knocks him out. And then the second fight, he schools him.
Yeah, I know. Then he retired then and said, oh, I'm leaving boxing.
He's done.
Till he gets the paycheck.
You know, it's just, you know, some fighters have it, you know, maybe the money's too good or they get comfortable what they have. It's more of a mindset. That's one people don't really understand boxing. It's more psychological than physical.
There you have it. More psychological than physical. Wise words from George Diaz. Stay tuned for more. FESNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. No, anything.